So we're at Rivington, it's July, it's piss wet through. We're going to slide around some trails and see what happens today. We've got Hugo with us and I've got Big Al. Let's get it!
Goes in crazy mode. Get at least one of these every ride. I'm better. So anyone living in the UK will know that July has been pretty shocking so far weather-wise. It's the 19th today. It's gonna be a pretty wet one, I think, but I'm sure it'll be fun. Also, on a new bike, not by choice. Both mine and the wife's bike was stolen from the house, from the shed, about 3 weeks ago, which is just feels horrendous. Anyone who knows mountain biking is a real kind of like mental assistance. Just sits you downtime. It's makes you feel so much better about everything, and when they take that away and it's the thing that you enjoy the most and it's the thing that helps you cope with situations like this, it's a real kick in the balls. So I'm off at a Bronson and onto a Nomad. I've had a few rides in. I've just got a new all-in shock for it as well, so see how that pans out. So a bit of test riding today and ride some sloppy trails and see what happens. So a little message to the mountain bike community, just lock your bikes down. I was definitely lax on security. Not anymore, but it can happen. It does happen. It would appear bikes are getting stolen to order. It's unlikely it's the scroats from around the corner with such a high-end bike, but shed, shackles, thick chains that can't be cut through without serious power tools. Get some cameras, CCTV, whatever. It's just, it is worth it. It's a small expense compared to replacing your bike. We got an insurance payout, but hey up, he's off again. Didn't cover the full amount for the bikes that we wanted to build, so definitely out of pocket. So it's worth spending £500. Locking your bikes down properly for sure. San Marino! Right, let's get it! Trying to get a feel for this bike today and this new shock. It's completely changed the balance between the front and the rear. On a flyer today. Woo. This is faster than I want to go. Like a beast today. You're riding like a beast. Woo! Yeah. Oh, I'm gonna slow a bit. Oh shit. Thank you. Woo! Such a good run. Yeah! Nice one. That was awesome. So a little rundown on the Nomad versus the Bronson. I think it's kind of, if you're a Santa Cruz rider, or if you know these bikes, you'll probably, don't take a genius to work out. This Nomad isn't quite as good as climbing, not quite as good as at flatter trails, but very similar natured bike really. They do feel very similar. This one obviously is just a little bit better at doing the heavier, harder hits than the Bronson is. The Bronson's better at pedaling and on the flat stuff, so pretty obvious really. But enjoying it so far. The orange shock is proving so far so good. Really enjoying it. Better than the stock Super Deluxe that came on the bike.
Leading
out.
Am I going?
Go on, go for it.
Hang on, I'll not be going.
No problem. Al's nursing an injured knee, so we're going to call it. Ah, took a much better line over that than I did. Oh, the squeaky brakes are back. Oh, they're kicking the mud up now. You didn't do a very good job of it. Oh, you go shortcut in there. Nice.
I was trying to pedal, I just couldn't do it.
The old way. It's fine, it's a bit skittish. I'm back. Second ride of the day. I've traded Al in for Mushy B, because bless him, his knee's all knackered and he was really struggling, so thought I'd come back and we'll ride some lower laps, have some fun. Here we are at the Pigeon Tower. Ride what we commonly refer to as the Tower of Terror. Oh, disturbed the pigeon. Feeling starting to get this dialed in a bit now, I think. Oof, foot down. A bit too wide on that one. Gotta remember to stay a bit further back on this bike. Doesn't want you over the bars. In the same way that the Bronson did. Wants you a little bit more neutral. Okay. And we're off to the left here. Ooh, it's a bit sloppy. Hey. This is very slimy. This is one of those just get low down and hope for the best. And we're through. It's a slimy one today. I've got mud in my eye. Check out the view. This isn't a bad view either. Mushy B. Nicely done. Yeah. Well done, Mosh. Great job. Oh, well held. This is super tech in the wet. Stay right, remember? In a bit, sorry. Yeah! The bike's dancing! Stay right, that's it, get that leg down. Nice one. Mosh leading us up our final climb. to the pike. Doing a fabulous job of strengthening those legs. Nice views. Look at that. So we're just finishing up. That's been an awesome day. Two rides. One with Al, one with the mush. It's been a lot of fun. Tracks are quite greasy. It only adds to the fun. Yeah, so we're really happy the sun's come back. Not sure how long it's here to stay for, but we're certainly making the most of it. That's what you gotta do.
Night rides.
Night rides. Yeah, it's been awesome. Back. Yeah, it's been really good fun. So just what we needed. We've had a crap few weeks and yeah, just needed a bit of R&R, so all good. So until next time, we'll catch you soon.